forget about that stale cereal or oatmeal. Joey Perez is live on your radios to provide you with the Eggs, Bacon, and Joey. You are now listening to the Eggs, Bacon, and Joey Morning Show.
Good morning, everybody. 9:30 exactly this morning, March 7, 2016. Happy Monday to you all. And good morning to our friends at 92.5 FM, 102.9 FM, 94.7 FM, and also KYA in San Francisco. 559-836-5386 is the number to call. And also nationwide online at kfunradio.com. Don't forget about our free app, which you can download today on your iPhone and Android app store. It's called KFUN 92.5. Download it. It's free. What's better than free, everybody? And at the same time, you can listen to the Eggs, Bacon, and Joey Morning Show on demand 24/7 whenever you want throughout the day. Whether you're at the gym, whether you're at work, whether you're running errands, whatever. Hook it up to your Bluetooth and listen to us on demand. All right, good morning to everybody. Once again, happy Monday to you all. There's a new show that is coming to the E! Network, and it's called the LA Clippers Dance Squad, and it's premiering March 15th at 10 p.m. March 15th at 10 p.m. on E! The LA Clippers Dance Squad gives fans an in-depth look at what it takes to be a member of an elite dance team in pro sports, on and off the court. From auditions and rehearsals to balancing personal challenges and professional ambitions, this docuseries shows what it really takes to make it to the floor of the Staples Center in Los Angeles and dance for basketball fans while representing a high-profile global brand. Dreams will be fulfilled and relationships will be tested when the LA Clippers Dance Squad takes center court beginning Tuesday, March 15th at 10 p.m. Eastern and Pacific on E! Following all new episodes of Total Divas only on E! So, before we get to Hannah, who's going to be joining us here on the show, let's play a quick clip of what LA Clippers Dance Squad is all about.
This is the world of the LA Clippers Dance Squad, where the routines are fierce and the women are elite performers. Here in the heart of Hollywood, they perform for thousands and are surrounded by glamour and fame. These ambitious dancers must be perfect 90 seconds at a time. They come from all walks of life, and are ambassadors of a $2 billion brand.
People are going to look up to you, and I want to be that person.
The Clippers have been reinvented under new ownership. And now, the team's dancers are more visible than ever. This year, the dance squad has a new creative director.
Ladies, if you know that you don't know the choreography, you should be doing a full out.
And she demands the best.
People can get fired. We chose 20, we don't have to keep 20.
Hundreds competed for a spot on this year's squad, but only 20 talented women.
I am going to kick ass out there.
We'll get to pursue their dreams on and off the court.
There it is, folks. LA Clippers Dance Squad. Once again, March 15th on E! At 10 p.m. Eastern and Pacific. And it is my pleasure to introduce one of the stars of the show this morning. Good morning to Hannah C.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Welcome to the show and welcome to Eggs, Bacon, and Joey. Happy Monday to you. I hope that you don't have the case of the Mondays this morning.
No. We had rehearsal yesterday and got rehearsal later on tonight. So I have just been at it for a while.
Well, that is good. Hannah, I got to ask you, obviously you are from Lake Charles, Louisiana, right?
Yes, the Dirty South.
The Dirty South. Now, tell us about Lake Charles. Is it like a small town? Because obviously New Orleans is your big city in Louisiana. Where's Lake Charles exactly?
So Lake Charles is about 3 hours west of New Orleans, close to the Texas border. It is a small town, and I think that's kind of what inspired me to move. just being there and seeing the opportunities that could present itself to me, like, on the West Coast. It inspired me.
Now, tell us about your early career in Lake Charles. Like, for example, did you start at a local dance studio there? What? How did you get involved in dance and performance?
I started dancing when I was 4. I danced basically my entire career up until high school, and then I cheered in the NFL for the New Orleans Saints for 2 football seasons.
Wow, what was that like?
It was the best thing at my in my life during that time, and it gave me the platform to be where I am today. I love dancing for a sports team.
So when you got to L.A., and you get to sunny California, was it a big change from your hometown and also New Orleans?
Absolute culture shock. It was, but great. Such a great place to be in. Out of my element. I was thrown into this. Moved out here with 2 suitcases. Most rewarding thing I've done in my life.
And were you looking for any Cajun food out in L.A.?
I had to create my own. I've called my mom for recipes many times. All right, Mom, how do I cook this etouffee? I don't remember. But, yeah, I've learned to cook even better.
That is hilarious.
At home, had to create my own Cajun food here.
That is hilarious. Well, I got to ask you, this is a huge show that's coming to the E! Network on March 15th, starting March 15th at 10 p.m. It's called the L.A. Clippers Dance Squad. Tell us about this competition, because only 20 were selected out of hundreds of thousands of contestants. How grueling was this competition?
Yeah, it was a cutthroat audition process. You'll see in our first episode a lot of emotion. I could probably cure the drought in Los Angeles if my tears were to fall down on the streets.
Wow.
How often I was crying during the audition process. It was very, very tough. Competition is fierce out here. We're in L.A. We have a lot of talent out here.
Now, you had to make a lot of sacrifices, right? Because, there's some information that says that you had to give up a lot of things, not only, you know, leaving your hometown, but also leaving your boyfriend.
Yeah, I did. I had to end a relationship with a guy that I had been seeing for about 3 years. It was tough. Something that I'm still dealing with today, and you'll see on the show that it wasn't a clean breakup.
Wow. If you're talking about sacrifices, those are like some of the ultimate sacrifices. I mean, you know, leaving your home, you know, and leaving kind of the comfortable scenario that you were in, but at the same time, you moved to L.A., and now you have bigger opportunities that await you as well, right? I mean, performing on the floor at the Staples Center, that's got to be a huge achievement for you.
Oh, absolutely. I wake up every morning and I'm so blessed to be living the life that I am. It's something I've dreamed about since I was young, and I'm actually doing it. And it's been the craziest journey, but so satisfying.
I love it. And I will ask you this, because there's a lot of people within the dance community that are tuning in this morning. Now, what advice would you give to someone that's, pursuing a dream of becoming a dancer, becoming a performer, that lived in a small town just like yourself? What are the steps that they should take to try to get out there and make a name for themselves?
Intense training. Go to class. Take class as many times as you can. Learn from different choreographers. Learn from your mistakes. And never give up on your dreams, because it can happen. It can happen to anyone. You can do this.
So this first episode is going to be happening March 15th at 10 p.m. You obviously are going to be on the show with the other competitors that were selected. Now, this first episode, you talked about how it's going to be grueling. You're going to see a lot of tears. You're going to see a lot of drama. What can people expect throughout the entire season on the L.A. Clippers Dance Squad?
Like you said, we're a team of 20 girls, and Savannah said it really great in one of the lines from the show, with girls comes drama. There is going to be conflict between us, but ultimately we're a sisterhood. We have each other's back, but we spend a lot of time together. So there is definitely some drama.
Well, you know what I could see? I could see you doing some great things in your career. And also, I can see you having a Cajun cooking show one day.
Oh, I would love that. I will cook for you. Come on over.
Really? You got to tell me about this Cajun food. I'm not really familiar with Cajun food. Like, what exactly is the greatness about it?
The spice, rice, all the flavor, crawfish, everything. I'll cook for you.
All right. I love it. Well, thank you so much, Hannah, for joining us once again. It is the LA Clippers Dance Squad, and it's premiering March 15th at 10 p.m. on the E! Network. Hannah, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy schedule, and we wish you the best of luck, okay?
Of course. Thank you, Joey. Thank you for having me.
All right. Hannah C. from LA Clippers Dance Squad, thank you once again for joining me this morning. And once again, folks, do not miss it. March 15th. That's right. March 15th on the E! Network. It is LA Clippers Dance Squad. And there you have it. Hannah's going to be cooking some Cajun food. I'm already excited. That's going to be amazing. Cajun food delivered by Hannah from the LA Clippers Dance Squad. I want to thank her for joining us this morning. All right. We continue on with more Eggs, Bacon, and Joey Morning Show. Do not go anywhere. We are live. Happy Monday to you all. We'll be right back.
Living like a lover with a red eye phone. Looking like a trans, like a video man. Devilish and warm, can I be your man? Wrestling and dancing and fashion in the day. Television is my baby cool night. Sometimes, anytime, sugar me sweet. Little miss of innocence, sugar. From my head to my feet, yeah.